Okay, so today I'm going to answer a couple of quick questions about how Tai Chi, or why, you know, why I do Tai Chi, why Tai Chi is my main, my base art, why I still do it every day, every night. You know, when I'm finished training here, I go to a shrine on the way back home, and I do Tai Chi about midnight each night. So I'll explain why and how it is very relevant to combatives, how it can actually bring you confidence, and how you can walk with that intent, walk with, even with that whole don't fuck me kind of, don't fuck with me kind of vibe, don't fuck me, maybe you want that kind of vibe, I don't know. But the point being is that, look, you know, you've got to be a deterrent sometimes, and you've also got to have that situational awareness. I can't even talk, I woke up, I've been speaking Japanese since then. So anyways, point being is that, you know, it's all about mindfulness, okay, mindfulness. And they say that Tai Chi is moving meditation a lot of the time, and I do agree with that, but, you know, when you are doing Tai Chi, you are synchronizing your, mainly your breath and your movement. Later on we talk about intent and all that sort of thing, but your breath and your movement, your breath is highly attached to your emotions, as they say, and your movement, well, that actually is based from your posture. So let me talk about that for a second. Excuse the mess over there, by the way. The guys have been sparring and are sweaty as fuck, so they put it out in the near the heater. Anyways, so when you've got correct postural alignment, so when you're actually sitting so that your chest is facing forward, but it's not actually puffed out like this. You're a little bit sunk here in the shoulders and everything, and you're tucked your ass in, as you'll see in the different postures throughout my different videos and DVDs and stuff like that. But what you're actually doing is just like meditation, because meditation, one of the first things is correct posture. So sitting in a relaxed but also proper posture. So it can actually take a little while for you to get used to that posture if your structure isn't actually used to that. Okay. Some people don't have the flexibility. I don't have very good flexibility. I mean, you know, coming out of hospital after brain surgery, I couldn't move very much. We'll talk about that later in the limitations bit. But anyway, that's one of the things. And look, when you... in meditation, a lot of time we talk about, you know, when you have correct posture, it actually has a massive effect on a positive mentality, a positive mindset, okay, a positive mental attitude. And with that positive mental attitude, that not only allows you to be mindful, as in more aware of yourself, what you're doing, your environment, the relationship between yourself and anybody else, even in positioning, okay, even in terms of the person's voice or their non-verbal communication, all these things, and it comes from mindfulness. So that's really why I highly, highly recommend Tai Chi for those people who are serious about not only their martial arts, but also combatives, because that next level, you know, mindfulness that you are going to achieve from doing Tai Chi is gonna help you expand, develop and maintain your situational awareness, okay? And that's one of the main things about combatives, about, you know, being able to have those risk management skills in place. If you're not mindful of what the fuck it is you're doing, how are you going to detect and deter any sort of oncoming potential threat, as in a risk? So your risk management skills are not going to be there if you're not mindful. That's what I'm trying to say. So it all starts with posturing. And when people sort of peacock and they do this, yeah, can I do one, motherfucker, like that, they're really putting on a front, okay? You don't need to do that. Like in Muay Thai, sometimes we'll be out here and make ourselves look bigger before we come in, when we have distance between ourselves and the opponent, because it's at a safe range for one, but also we look bigger for intimidation purposes, okay? But you can do the exact same thing, and I learned this from working doors for a long time, just by looking at somebody. The look that you give someone, to look through them and let them know, I'm not fucking scared of you, cunt, like that, is, you know, can be just as good as a deterrent, just as good of a deterrent. Your voice as well, step the fuck back, something like that can be just as good as a deterrent. So the other thing is that a lot of people in the Tai Chi sects and the Taoist group that I'm involved with and the Buddhist groups that I also study with and have mentors from and that sort of thing, some of them will say, hey, you do Tai Chi, then why do you do combatives and martial arts? Why do you shoot? Why do you train to stab? Why do you fucking do all this stuff? I don't use the word fuck, I do too much apparently, but anyway. The point is that they don't understand that Tai Chi itself is a Taoist practice. As is Chinese medicine, TCM, the massage, the cupping, the moxibustion, everything, feng shui, it's all relevant. Lion dance, it's all part of, they're all Taoist practices, okay? They're a reflection of the basic fundamental philosophies. But how do we know what good is if we don't understand what bad is? How do we understand peace if we don't understand violence? Okay, if we see violence, we always want to run away from that. We always want to shut that out and sort of escape that. That's one thing. But one day when you find yourself accidentally in a bad situation and you've got no other choice but to stand up for yourself and refuse to be a fucking victim, then that's when you're going to think, well, fuck, it's like having a weapon on you. Whether you carry whatever you carry, it could be this, you know what I mean? It could be a fucking bottle of a can of coffee, whatever. Point is that I'd rather always have it and not need it than need it and not have it. And that's the exact same thing with the combatives training, okay? I don't do it to mash people up, but I know I can, okay? If I have to, if that's necessary. It doesn't mean that I want to, but I know that I'm more than capable of doing it. And I did that on shouldn't say I did that, but I have experience doing that on doors for a long time. As I said, being a bouncer and that sort of thing. So you get to test your skills and all that sort of shit on a regular basis. But the point being is that I wouldn't have lasted that long if I wasn't doing my Tai Chi. So I get back to my original point of Tai Chi is such a good practice for those who want to obtain a next level of understanding in martial arts, because you go through all of your postures, all of your synchronization of movement, breath, and intent with Tai Chi. If you want to know more, look, get online. We've got online learning. It's a free week-long trial, and you can check out the Tai Chi course that we have, Raw Tai Chi. The only reason it's called Raw is because it has very different goals and objectives as to just doing a fucking form. It has you understand posturing, has you understand synchronization of breath, and it actually has a goal of creating, developing, and maintaining that ability for explosive energy. So anyways, there's a DVD on it as well. You can check in the link below. Thank you very much for watching. If you haven't already subscribed, and make sure you share this on Facebook. Check us out on Facebook and Instagram and all those other good things, but share this because there's other people in your group that might not understand what real Tai Chi is. Okay, it's not just a cosmic dance like my parents thought it was when I was doing it back in the day in high school and that, you know. It actually has very, very good qualities that you can develop as a martial artist and as a combative practitioner. So again, thank you very much for watching. Check out my personal pages, my personal channel as well, because I've got a lot of videos on personal development, which are also on my blogs at lukeholloway.com. Thanks again, and as always, stay safe.